Hello everyone, this is Abdesh Pratap Singh. In this video, I'm going to show how to build an image classification model and use it in AnnaDAP. So, what is image classification? A common use of machine learning is to identify what an image represents. For example, we might want to know what type of animal appears in the following photograph. The task of predicting what an image represents is called image classification. An image classification model is trained to recognize various classes of images. When we subsequently provide a new image as an input to the model, it will give us the output of the properties of images we have trained. So it is easy to identify the type of image with the highest probability. So where it can be used? So it can be used to identify cat or dog in an image, to identify various breeds of dogs, to identify diseases in a crop or plants. We can use pre-trained and optimized models to classify various kinds of objects, class of objects including people, activities, animals, plants and places. So in this video, I'm going to show how to use image classification model in Android app, as well as how to train the image classification model with your own data sets and with basic machine learning knowledge. So if you are familiar with machine learning and you are not able to develop good machine learning models, and using pre-built machine model, we can train the models with our own data sets. So with the help of transfer learning is a technique that shortcuts much of this by taking a piece of model that has already been built and reusing it in a new model with your custom data sets. So now I'm using Google Colab, and it is just similar to Jupyter Notebooks. I'll show you step-wise procedure how to train a machine learning model. So in the TensorFlow website, you can get many machine learning models that has been pre-built and trained as well. So to use our own data sets, you have to just collect the images. I'll show you. So you must use your own data sets. Like this. Name those folders, whatever you're going to train, name those folders. Suppose leaf model. I've taken leaves of jackfruit, mango and money plant. So I've collected all these images, and as you should collect as many as images you can connect, and collect them in a folder and store it in your Google Drive. Now I'll be sharing this Colab link in the description. So right now I'll be explaining step-wise procedure how to train a machine learning image classification model with your own custom data sets. So let's get started. So I'm not going in very specific about the code. Just I'll be showing you the procedure how to train a machine learning model, run these cells and connect this. See, it is running here, and connect your Google Drive where you have stored the data sets. And using this following code, here we are importing. This is a pre-built machine learning model available in the TensorFlow website. You can go there and you can see here by clicking. So next we'll be connecting Google Drive. So to connect Google Drive, just run this cell and it gives you the link. Just click on this link. Copy this line, copy this and paste it here. It is asking for authorization code. Control V and just enter it. So you'll be connecting Google Drive such that you can import your data sets wherever you have stored. So see, Google Drive has been mounted here. Go to, you can see here, drive has been connected. Go to your folder wherever you have stored the data sets. So I have stored data sets here, my training data, whatever I'm going to train. So here is my training data set. Just click it and copy the file path. After copying the file path, you just place the file path here, such that we could provide the folders in the form of data to this code. So run this cell by placing run this cell and next cell as well. So it shows 7177 images belong to three classes. I mean, I've taken just three folders. In the leaf dataset, I've taken jackfruit, mango, and money plant. So it is showing how many images are there. Next, defining a model. Run these cells. And here we'll be training the model after running the cells. Now you can see here, by training the model, you can get the accuracy. By training the model, you can get the accuracy. Here you can see the number 15. Means 15 times I am training the data, and each time the accuracy is changing. See here, accuracy was just 82%, and loss was 7120%. And next, accuracy improves as you train the data, and the accuracy improves. See here, 100% accuracy, and loss value will be decreasing. This means your model is getting accurate and more accurate, and that depends on your training data as well. The data which you have provided for training, so must be in folder. Suppose a flowers collection, all roses must be under one folder, and your images must differ in size. The light, suppose you are taking in a dim light or heavy light, and as well as colors, such that it is easy to identify variety of data sets. Next, here you can, after training the data sets, you can see here I've trained the data sets. Next, run the Excel. Here you can loss of the training data as well as accuracy, how it was changing. You can get in the form of plot. Next, run the cell to save the model. Here you can specify the folder name. Suppose you can specify my first model as well as the model name. So this model will be stored in the form of TensorFlow model. Okay, we'll be running the cell, and you can see this model has been saved in our Google Drive. So let's wait. So you can see here the model, the folder has been created, and the model name is leaf model. See, you can see here this particular folder is been created. Folder being created, and inside that you are having the TensorFlow model with SS folder, variables folder, and saved mobile.pb folder. Now, after training the TensorFlow model, you have saved it in your Google Drive. The problem comes. So TensorFlow Lite models, what is the need of converting to TensorFlow Lite models? So TensorFlow Lite models lets you deploy TensorFlow models to mobile as well as IoT devices. The code below shows how to convert trained TensorFlow model to TensorFlow Lite model. So here I've declared the TensorFlow Lite model name and where the path to store the TensorFlow Lite model. Just run this cell to make a directory mkdir. After making the directory, this particular code converts your TensorFlow model to TensorFlow Lite model and stores in this path. So let's wait till then it is converting. It has been saved in our Google Drive. So let's check, run this cell to make a directory mkdir. After making the directory, this particular code converts your TensorFlow model to TensorFlow Lite model and stores in this path. So let's wait till then it is converting. It has been saved in our Google Drive. So let's check. So you can see here in the saved TensorFlow Lite models. You can see leaf.tf.lite, because I have specified leaf.tf.lite in TensorFlow Lite models. So now next step, you download this model. So we are downloading this model to use it in an Android app. So download it. So meanwhile it is downloading. So I'll be sharing this code with you. Just you need to collect your own data set in the form of folders. Suppose you want to classify variety of dogs, make folders of each variety of dogs. Suppose or German Shepherd. You make a folder of all the dogs in a specific different folders of one category. After making the folder, upload it to the Google Drive. After uploading the Google Drive, run the cells, and just you need to connect your Google Drive by authorizing. Here already the code is being built for you. Just our here by running the cell, connect it to the Google Drive and share your path wherever you have stored the data, and run the remaining cells. And here you need to just specify how many times you wanted to train. Suppose you want to train 10 times. As much as times you train, the more the accuracy of the model increases. So if you train 15 times or 20 times, your model accuracy increases. Accuracy in a sense, the probability of identifying a particular image increases, and it is easily able to identify what kind of image is that. Next, after training the model, you save the model in your Google Drive by specifying the path here. After saving the model, convert the model to TensorFlow Lite model such that you will be able to use that model in mobile apps as well as IoT devices. I'll be sharing this code in the description. After converting the TensorFlow Lite model, see, I've downloaded this model here. Next, we'll be using this TensorFlow Lite model in the Android app. You'll be having doubt how to collect my data sets. So if you're not having the way to collect your data set, you can get the data sets. Go to the website Kaggle data sets. There you can find your data sets you wanted to search. See, Kaggle data sets. Go there and search for your data sets, whether you want a particular rice crop diseases or images of various kinds of dogs, flowers, or anything. You can search here. Various data sets are available, and just download it and save it in your Google Drive. Once you have downloaded the TensorFlow Lite model, and when you put it in your app, there are many disadvantages. Like the app size, the binary size of your app increases. That means the user has to download the your app, including the TensorFlow Lite file. And as well as when you're training, you want to improve the accuracy of your model, you must update the app, and the users should update the apps regularly when you want to improve your accuracy of the model. So this disadvantage can be solved by hosting your model into the cloud. So to overcome these disadvantages, I'll be showing you a shortcut how to host your model, and when you want to replace your model, users need not download your app again and again. Just you can replace the model whichever you are newly trained with the pre-existing model, or as well as you can keep one temporary model in your Android app, as well as you can host it in your Google cloud. So when the model gets changed, the cloud the app downloads the model automatically into the user's app using Wi-Fi. So MLKit, Firebase MLKit lets you host custom models. So here you can host your custom models, and see, you host your custom models using Firebase to reduce binary size and make sure your app is always using the most recent version of available of your model. So this makes easy for you to train the model, and I'm going to show how to use these models. Now I'll show you how to host your custom model in the Firebase MLKit. So create a project. Next, come to the MLKit of Firebase. Next, click on custom model, add model. Click on add model. It ask you to specify one name. Specify one name and click continue. Now it is asking you to specify the TensorFlow Lite model which we have downloaded from the Google Colab, and we will be sharing that file here. So go to downloads and get that model and specify that model, and it will be uploading. It will be uploaded here. Once it is uploaded, then you can use it this hosted model in your Android app using Firebase MLKit SDK. That helps you to interact with the model. So it is uploading. It will be verifying our model. See, now it is done. Our model has been hosted. So just whenever you want to replace the model, just click it on the replace model and upload the new file which you have trained and downloaded the TensorFlow Lite model. Next, we'll be using this model in the Android app. After hosting your custom model, next we have to follow these guidelines provided by the Firebase MLKit. So add these dependencies in order to access your hosted model in your Android app build.gradle file. Open your build.gradle file and add these dependencies here. After adding these dependencies, next step, host your model. After hosting your model, we'll specify the conditions required to download the model, and as specified here, I've created an activity name as leaf model activity, and initially you must specify the input dimensions. So while training, we have specified these input dimensions. One is to 224, 224, 3. Next, output dimension is, it specifies three properties because I've taken three set of images, that is jackfruit leaf, money plant leaf and mango leaf. So just as specified three. If you are specifying, you are training the data or model with more, you specify it here. Next, specify the options. Option set of inputs, set of output, input format and output format. Next, Firebase download. So here it is specified the conditions required to download. Just copy these conditions and paste it here. After specifying the conditions, the most important line is this model name. Whatever you have specified the name while hosting, just paste it here, this condition. After pasting it condition, check whether update is available for the model or not. If update is not available, the model which was pre-downloaded will be used, or if update is available, it will be downloading it again, and the condition is it requires Wi-Fi connection while downloading. So this code specifies, this code checks. So remote model, the model name you have specified here, and the conditions. The conditions used that it requires Wi-Fi. Next, whether it is update available, yes, the model was downloaded, or it will be downloading it again after downloading the model. Next, Firebase model manager dot get installed. If it is downloaded, is model downloaded? It checks it is downloaded. Okay, it is downloaded. Next, go for the interpreter. Next, interpreter is downloaded. After download, success, or else you will get error. Next, we'll be capturing the image. So after I have specified the button on clicking the button, the decode method is going to run, and the camera kit view captures the image. The camera kit view returns the image in the form of bytes, but the model requires the input in the form of bitmap. So we are converting using this line. We'll be converting the model the bytes into bitmap, and we'll be specifying the input. So add input method. So this is the add input method which we have created here. And in add input method, this is pixels. We are converting pixels such that it can accept the input. After specifying the inputs. Next, interpreter will be running the interpreter, and if it was successful in running the interpreter, it returns the probabilities. So probabilities means in the order which we have specified the folders, it returns in the same order. Suppose I specified money plant leaf folder first, it gives the money plant leaf folder. Next, you can use these probabilities to print. I have used it here. I'll be finding this is the names. See names, which probabilities I'll be getting here from the above method. Next, I'll be printing these probabilities by finding the highest probabilities, and I'll be add text view. In the text view, I'll be showing the highest probability. So that helps us to identify what actually image belongs to which category. So if it is jackfruit, the maximum probability will be of jackfruit. If it is money plant, the maximum probability will be of money plant. Thus, you can see that your model is working. Now I'm gonna show the working model of the app. So here is the working model of our app. First, we are taking an image of mango leaf, and the model is predicting that the image is a mango leaf with the highest probability. Next, we are taking a jackfruit image, and the model is predicting this leaf is a jackfruit leaf with highest probability. And third, we are taking a money plant leaf image, and is predicting, model is predicting that is a money plant image with highest probability.